Hello everyone, my name is Manasvi and I'm part of the Azure Identity team at Microsoft. As a developer, when it comes to understanding how applications access data, we talk about two types of permissions in the Microsoft Identity platform. These are delegated permissions and application permissions. This video will be a quick guide to understand delegated permissions and how they could be leveraged when accessing resources such as Microsoft Graph. When we say delegated permissions, we are talking about a scenario where there's a client application trying to access a resource on behalf of a signed-in user. Hence, an access token issued to the application would identify the user as the subject of the token. Additionally, when we talk about authorization here, it is a combination of what the user is authorized to do plus what the application is authorized to do on behalf of that user. Hence, both the user and the application must be authorized separately to make the request. Owing to all these reasons, these kind of permissions are also known as delegated access, impersonation access, or also app plus user access. Now let us look at an example on how the configuration looks like for a delegated permission. For this, I will switch over to the Azure portal and demonstrate an application registration. I'm now creating a new application registration in the Azure portal and call this Delegated Access Demo. I will add a redirect URI for this application using the web platform that points to my local host. Once we click Register at the bottom, the application registration process is now complete. We are going to use this application to call a Microsoft Graph API that lists the user's manager information. A quick look at the Microsoft documentation here tells us that the least privileged delegated permissions we need for this API to execute is user.read.all. First, we will look at the experience when this permission is not set on the application registration. For ease of demonstration, I will leverage Postman. Postman is the tool used to build and test APIs as per your need. It can help in sending API requests to the web server and return the response easily. Now, the API endpoint I'm trying to access in Graph is one that retrieves manager details for the signed-in user. To execute this request, we will need an access token. For this purpose, under the Authorization tab, I have populated necessary values to configure a new access token. I will select Get New Access Token option, and in the prompt, I will enter my credentials. Once I have the access token, I will use that same token to make this GET request. As you can see, the response is a 403 forbidden error. Why did we get a 403? Let's go back and look at what kind of permissions we have configured at this point in time for this application against Microsoft Graph. For this, I'm switching to the Azure portal, navigating to the Azure Active Directory blade, and then finding the specific app registration that we created earlier. Here, I will open the API permissions blade on the left to get the list of permissions configured on this app. As you can see, at this point, we only have Microsoft Graph's user.read permission set as a delegated permission. Since we observe the documentation calls out that we need a minimum of user.read.all permission to make the API call, let us now add it. To do this, I go to Add a Permission and select Microsoft Graph API. Then I select Delegated Permissions under this and then use the search bar to look for user.read.all. Once found, I will enable this permission and select Add Permissions at the bottom. Since this is a permission that requires admin consent, hit the option that allows you to grant admin consent to the tenant. Note, you need to be an admin to be able to do this. Now let us switch back to Postman and see if there's a change in behavior. We need to generate a new access token now since we have changed the permissions on the application. I will again go ahead and enter my credentials here. Once I get the token, I will also quickly decode this token using a tool like JWT.ms to check the scope set. Under scopes, you will now see user.read.all included as well. Now, if we make the same MS graph call in Postman, we get a 200 OK result along with the details of the manager for this user. This concludes the demo of using delegated permissions to invoke a graph API. In summary, here are some important points to remember when it comes to delegated permissions. Delegated permissions authorize an app to access a resource on behalf of the signed-in user. The effective permissions on the app is the intersection of the permissions of the app, which is what the application is allowed to do, and the permissions allowed for the user, which is what the user is allowed to do. These permissions can be granted by a regular user, although sometimes some permissions require an admin to step in and grant the consent. I hope this video helped in giving a clear understanding on what delegated permissions are and how they can be leveraged in your environments. Thank you for watching.